In today's lecture, we will discuss about the plant movements. When we talk about movements, then in animals, you can clearly observe the movements that they displace or they move from one place to another place. But in case of plants, that movement is not visible, though these plants also move through different in response to different environmental stimuli, and there are different techniques through which you can demonstrate the plant movements. These techniques includes time lapse motion picture photography, and then observing their reactions at interval of several hours, not in at the interval of minutes, but in interval of several hours, you can observe the reaction of the plants simply to the environmental stimuli. And third way to demonstrate the plant movements is that the noting the change in the position of various organs. You will clearly see that position of various organs changes with the time. So this is also an indication of plant movements. Most obvious movements are the growth movements. These growth movements are basically the change in the position of organs such as stem, roots, and leaves resulting from an enlargement of the cells or from an increase in the number of cells, or that both can happen. These growth movements are basically irreversible and may occur because of equal or unequal cell division. There are three basic types of growth movements. First movement is the tropical movement, and that tropical movement is because of environmental stimuli. Various environmental factors affect these kinds of movements. Second type of movement is the anastic movement. That is basically the internal environmental conditions or internal timing mechanisms which affect these types of growth movements. And third type of movement is the nutational movement. These are basically the bending movements of stem, root, and leaves, and these are caused by difference in the growth of the organs in the plant that could be resulted from the environmental conditions. So these are basically three different types of growth movements, and we will discuss in detail about these movements in future lectures. Thank you.